So today we have November Raves and Rejects. I never posted an October Raves and Rejects, but I did post my five favorite products on my website. So I'll link that down below if you missed that. Got the peppermint mocha extra shot. We're ready to go. I cannot believe it's almost already December. I haven't even been to Target yet and scoped out the holiday section. I'm slacking. I did just film a Shadow and Schmooze on the look I'm wearing right now. So if you wanna see that, I believe it'll be up before this video. I'll put it in the down bar if it is. But today, we are going to be talking about my favorite products of the last basically 2 months. There's a lot of shit in here, so let's get into it. The first thing I have to mention, if you follow me on Instagram, you've already seen me rave about this, but this is the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Press Powder. They make a loose powder version as well, but this is just the translucent press powder version. And I like this so much better than the loose powder version. This is freaking amazing at setting your makeup. This is by far my favorite setting powder I've ever used. It makes you literally look flawless. First of all, the finish doesn't look powdery. It just looks like, literally, it does look poreless. I was having issues with this foundation not staying throughout the day. This is the Too Faced Born This Way foundation in the shade Snow, which is also a favorite this month. These two together are like my new favorite combo. This needs a good powder to set it, at least on my skin. This combo lasts literally all day for me. I put on my makeup at about 7 in the morning for work, and I don't take off my makeup till about 9 p.m. at night. So favorite foundations this month, I have two. The first is the one I just mentioned, and the second is a Makeup Forever Ultra HD Stick. I have a whole review. I'm not gonna go too in-depth. The shade Snow is a little bit yellow on my skin tone, I feel like, but for some reason, I feel like it works, and it's light enough. The Makeup Forever Ultra HD Stick Foundation, I was so not expecting to like this. I haven't had great success with stick foundations in the past. They're usually like a little bit difficult to blend out or just don't have the best coverage. This is, holy crap, you guys. First of all, this is completely full coverage. You can build it up to full coverage when you first put it on just with a thin layer. It's a good, I would say like a heavy medium to full coverage. I would recommend using a mattifying primer underneath this. It can look super dewy and get oily throughout the day. It feels like you're blending nothing when you blend it out on your face. I also did a first impression review on this, and I've been switching off between these two foundations every single day since I got them both. Yeah, speaking of mattifying primers, my favorite mattifying primer has been the Makeup Forever Step 1 Skin Equalizer. They make 4 different ones. I've been testing out all of them, but this is my favorite so far. This is the mattifying version. It feels like kind of strange when you put it on your face. It gets like really tight. Kind of feels like you had Botox, but this legit works. I feel like it's really difficult to tell with primers whether or not it's actually working. I like to step-by-step introduce new products in. So like after I had these two down, then I brought in this primer, and this is what makes the whole routine. If you have oily skin, try this stuff out. Right now with the seasons changing and everything, I feel like I have combo skin. I usually have pretty normal skin, but my skin has been getting a little bit oilier throughout the day, and this just does the freaking job. I believe you can get this in travel size, so if you don't want to pay the full price, if you just want to test it out, get the travel size from Sephora. Everything in here I'm like so excited to talk about that I don't even know where to start. While we're on the foundations, this sponge, this is not a beauty blender. If you see, it has a slanted side here, kind of like the Real Technique sponge. This is actually from the dual-ended, I think I have it in here. Okay, we got it, and the battery's dying, great. This comes with the Pure Cameo Contour Stick, and I'm not a fan of this, and that will be mentioned later. But this sponge, holy crap, this is seriously worth it to me to buy this stick, because this is better than the beauty blender in my opinion. It does not soak up as much foundation. When you wet it, it just feels different. Like, you don't have to squeeze as much water. It just applies it better. It has this point right here, so it's easy to get under your eyes if you're pressing in concealer. I really like using this flat side to apply my foundation. I'm not sure if they sell this by itself. I'll do some research when I'm editing this, and I'll put it in the description box. Next, my new favorite face wash of life. I love my Neutrogena Acne Stress. No, it's not Acne Stress. It's the one I always mention, in the like silver tube. That has exfoliating beads in it, so I wanted to get something that was just a cleanser that didn't have any kind of exfoliating in it. It's the Biore Blemish Fighting Ice Cleanser, and I love products where you can feel it like tingling, or it feels like icy. When you rub it into your face, it totally has this cooling sensation. It has 2% salicylic acid in it. My skin reacted to this really well. I've been using this for about, I want to say a month and a half now. I've been testing out a ton of new face products, and my skin has been breaking out lately, but I love this stuff. I use it every single day. I use it in the morning, and then I use my exfoliator at night usually. I've just been liking this stuff. Are we crooked now?
Yeah.
How does this happen? Camera battery just died again, but we are back. Can you guys hear that? Don't remember what we ended off with. My new favorite bronzer is the Body Shop Honey Bronze. This is in the shade 01. This is perfect if you have pale skin. If you don't have pale skin, get the shade up because it blends out so... If you don't have pale skin, get the shade up from this because it just blends out so easily. I'm wearing it right now. You'll see how it applies in this tutorial on this look. Shout out to Holly Eats Lipstick. I love Holly. If you're not subscribed to her channel already, you need to be. I'll link it down below. She's used this for a while and I finally decided to pick it up and I'm so glad I did because it is freaking amazeballs. So I have two hair products that I'm in love with. I also have other hair products that I mentioned on the blog post, so you can check that out if you're interested. But this is the tea tree oil line. And when I was in Sacramento, my cousin has her like beauty license, so we went to Cosmoprof, and I have never been to Cosmoprof before. It is like Disneyland if you're into beauty and hair stuff. So this came in a kit, like a holiday set, with a little serum thing that I haven't actually tried yet, but I think it was like $15 for all three products, which is insane for this brand. This is the blow dry primer lotion, and then this is a hair mask. So this one you use obviously in the shower just as a normal hair mask. I apply it from about here down. It smells heavenly. I love the smell of tea tree. This is actually a thinner mask than I'm used to. It's kind of runny, like it's not as thick as the macadamia one or other hair masks I've tried. This one smells the same, but this is actually a kind of like lotion thing that you put in when your hair is damp before you blow dry it. This makes my hair so soft. It's so much more tamed than my hair usually is after I blow dry it. I could go out of the house after I blow dry my hair when I use this stuff. Normally I can't. Normally I'm still like lion status. Loving this. This Ofer Cosmetics You Glow Girl Highlight. This is a collaboration with Dupe That, the Instagram account. So beautiful. I mentioned this on Instagram. This is the pinkier shade, obviously. So freaking beautiful. There it is. Just gives you the prettiest glow. It doesn't look chalky at all. It just gives your face the most beautiful highlight. And if you use the code Kathleen40, you can get 40% off of your whole Ofra order. Another highlight I wanted to quickly mention is ColourPop Fanny Pack. This is one of their Super Shock Cheek highlights. So it is a cream highlight. I posted about this on Instagram too. If you're not following me on Instagram, you should be. It's the same as my YouTube name. This is a cream highlight, but it is white. So if you have pale skin, you are going to love this. It is beautiful. It's like a silvery white highlight. Also looks great on the inner corner or on your Cupid's bow. I think this is limited edition, so if you're curious, you should probably pick it up now. Wanted to mention these JCAT Beauty Triple Baked Eyeshadows. These are so freaking pretty. I'm wearing one of them on my lid right now, like under this crazy amount of glitter. But my favorite three trios are Baked Alaska, which is this cool toned grayish taupey one, Dolce de Leche, which I'm pretty sure I'm going to include this in my drugstore wedding tutorial, which I am going to be doing, this trio, which is Cherry Fudge Sundae. I have swatches on Instagram. I think these retail for like $6. You can get them at Ulta online. The Ulta in Seattle is super shitty, so they never have this kind of stuff in store, but you might be able to find it in store as well. These are great. Battery's dying again, so we're going to get through this right now. These are the Eylure number 126. Look at these bad boys. When you put these on, they look like you have mink lashes on. They are so full. No words. I definitely want to try more lashes from Eylure. $7 or whatever these are. They're like under $10. These look way higher end lashes than they actually are. I also wore these in my healthy lifestyle video. This is now the fifth time that the battery has died. I'm about to chuck this camera out of the window. I'm determined to get done right now. The last rave that I want to mention this month is the Kat Von D Shade and Light eye palette. I don't know why I resisted for so long buying this. I just felt like I didn't need another matte eyeshadow palette, but I'm telling you, there's something about this. The shades are just so easy to blend out. There's warm tones, there's cool tones in here. I use a mix of these two every single day in my crease. That's all I wear to work, with some mascara. Even though these are all neutral mattes, I feel like there's a ton of different looks that you can do with this. In my opinion, if you don't have a good matte eyeshadow palette, this is the one that you need. Shit, the battery's going again. Super happy I got this. Loving it. My only reject this month is the Pure... they changed to Pure Cosmetics. I keep wanting to call them Pure Minerals. This is the Pure Cosmetics Cameo Contour. This just didn't work for me. It wasn't absolutely horrible. It's just after using the Makeup Forever stick, this is just like didn't cut it. Doesn't blend out well, doesn't have very good coverage. For being the light shade, the contour shade is like way too dark for my skin tone. This shade is actually light enough, which is surprising. It's just not, I just would never use this as an all over kind of foundation. It says it's a contour foundation, so it is supposed to be a foundation, not just like a highlight under your eye, forehead kind of situation. Wouldn't recommend this, but I do really like the sponge that comes with it. That was everything. I hope you guys like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up so I know. Love you guys. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Bye. Hallelujah. Thumbnail. Quick.